Rebbe used to come to learn with Rebbe. And the Aaron Navi used to come every day to learn in Bet Midrash of Rabbi Yehuda Anasi. And the Gemara brings down the story that he came there of Rosh Chodesh. It says that Eliyahu Navi did not come. The Gemara brings down says the following, that the next day when Eliyahu Navi appeared in the Bet HaMidrash, Rabbeinu HaKadosh told him, like this, ah, there, mon der, come no more. What happened? You didn't come yesterday? How come you're not coming? Bitul Torah. You know what he said to him? I couldn't come. Why? Busy. What are you busy with? He says, hey, Rosh Chodesh is a very special day. It's a day when I have to go and wake up. The Avot HaKdoshim. Avraham Avinu has to be woke up in the morning. I have to wake him up. I have to wash the Tilat Yadayim. Prepare him for his tefillah, he prays shaharit. I have to put him to sleep. By the time I put him in, it's time for mincha. I have to wake up Yitzhak Avinu. So when I have to pick up Yitzhak Avinu, he says, I wash his hands, I wake him up, I put him to sleep. The next day he says, then comes time to pray arvit. I wake up Yaakov Avinu. I have no time. He says, you have no time? Why? What's the big deal? Why are you doing so much bitul Torah? He says, wake all three of them up at the same time. You are Malach Abri. You are able to do things. Wake three of them up. Let them pray all together at the same time. The Gemara says, Eliyahu Navi told them, nah, I cannot do that. The Gemara says, why? So the Gemara says over there that if they all pray at the same time, there will be so much rachamim in Shamayim, the Geulah is going to come right then and there. Wow. Mashiach will come right away. So the Gemara says over there, Rabbeinu HaKadosh said to him, can I ask you a question? He says, I want information. He says, what? He says, tell me anybody down here on this world, on the land over here, that knows how to that has the same koach like the Avot HaKdoshim. He told him, yeah, of course there is. He says, who? Rabbi Chaya Ubana, your student Rabbi Chaya Agadol, and his two boys, Chizkiyah and Rabbi Yehuda. Now I tell you a little story. The Gemara Masechet Yevamot brings down, says, how was Chizkiyah and Rabbi Yehuda born? Do you know that? Rabbi Chaya had two children only. Didn't have more. It says they were twins. Two boys, twins. They were born 1 month apart. The Gemara says first was born one of the boys. Then, I don't know what happened. And then a month later, another delivery. Wow. So his wife went Mishika, she went crazy. She tricked him at the end. And she at the end came to a point of realizing there's no mitzvah for women. I shouldn't say this publicly. Women don't have the obligation of bringing children to this world. She took special medicine. It's not sold in the pharmacy today. Took medicine, shook. He says she became akara. She was not able to have children anymore at all. But can you imagine what kind of children she gave birth to? The Gemara says, Rabbi Yehuda, normally Rosh Chodesh, to make ta'anit asur, not allowed. You're supposed to eat, suhuda. It's a mitzvah to go home, to wash, make extra stuff, Rosh Chodesh. You, your children, tell them Rosh Chodesh Shvat. According to Bet Shammai, today is Rosh Hashanah. Like Tu B'Shvat, according to Bet Shammai. We have another 15 days, we'll be Tu B'Shvat Be'ezrat Hashem, New Year for New Year, for the trees, for the fruit of the trees. So Gemara is down over there, the Rabbi Yehuda made ta'anit. Eliyahu Navi left, he's not there. He makes ta'anit, gazar ta'anit. And it says over there that he made Rabbi Chaya and his two boys to go down to the Bima and to pray at the same time. One voice, three of them at the same thing. The Gemara brings down, says the following, that it ended up being over there that when they came to say Hashem, Sfatai, Titach, Ve'agita, came to Magen Avot, the world already started to, something is happening. So much rahamim. They came to Mechaya Metim, it says, Gemara says, Ragash Alma, the whole world started shaking. They said, Mashiv Aduach, strong wind started to blow. Morida Geshem, Bezah, started pouring rain, gushing down. They about to say Mechaya Metim, about to say Tusha, it says, the whole world started shaking. In Shabayim, they said, what's going on? Who revealed the secrets? Who spilled the beans? What happened over here? They said, Eliyahu Navi. They brought Eliyahu Navi. Over there, there's no concept of time. Mahyu, they gave him a patch over there. They bang him up, they beat him up. They beat him 60 times. And they told him, you made the trouble, go down there and stop them. Wow. So Eliyahu Navi came to the Bet Midrash of Rabbi Yehuda Anasi, and he appeared over there to them like a bear made out of fire. And he went in between them like this, ran around them. People got they didn't know what's going on, got scared. They stopped praying right then and there. They stopped to pray. The Kavanah was fun, that's it, everything fell apart. You see from here, Rabotai, Rosh Chodesh is a special time to play. Tefillot, Bakashot, Tahanunim. You have to, this is a day to ask for all the Yeshuot you want. Now they didn't know why they didn't want to pray, I see that. No, but listen, everybody has his koach to play. Everybody has the ability. Atach Tidim, Kavanah Basta, you have to ask from your heart. Hashem Itbarach. Is Karov Hashem Lechol Korav Hashem close to all those who call out to Him? Lechol Hashem Ikra'uhu Be'emet. But you have to call Him from the bottom of your heart. Ask! Hashem says, I'm ready to give you. Bakashot! obviously, if you want your bakasha to go through, chatati, aviti, pashati, say, Ribbono Shel Olam, I made avera, I made sins, please forgive me. Hashem forgives you the avirot. Then you could ask for everything you want. Do kabbalat malchut shamayim. Say, Hashem melech, Hashem hu Elokim. Hashem melech, Hashem alach. Ana Hashem Oshiana, ana Hashem atzlichana. And they say, Ribbono Shel Olam, please. Kama shiyotel Yeshua. Kama shiyotel. Bezat Hashem, parnasa tova, parnasa berevach, Yeshuot. All the good things, Bezat Hashem. A wonderful day. Don't forget, today is a special day. We have to celebrate it.